country.
So. I'm the hottest artist in the city.
No, you're not.
I'm definitely the hottest artist in the city.
No.
And I got, every song I put out is makes Billboard Top 100. I don't get no cosigns. I don't got no G-Eazy cosign. I don't got no Offset cosign. You know what I'm saying? Where, like, I'm self-made.
Welcome to Support This TV. And damn it, boy. Now, the little clip I used at the beginning was a clip of 6ix9ine being at the Breakfast Club today. 6ix9ine was on there. He said he was self-made. He has no co-signers in New York. He also said he was the king of New York, and he said he was the hottest artist out. Well, Charlamagne disagreed. Charlamagne said that Cardi B was bigger. He said, no, he was bigger than Cardi B. But the main question a lot of folks wanted to know, even the question that they asked him, was why was you rocking blue? Was you a Crip at some point? He said that in his neighborhood, it's Crips and Bloods. He said in his neighborhood, he's friends with some Crips. And he said he used to rock blue because his friends was Crips. He said he was never down. He said he was never jumped in or anything like that, any kind of slang you want to use for it. He said he never rolled with the Crips on that level of being a Crip. Only the fact that his friends were Crips. So he basically trying to say he was affiliated. He was never a full-blown Crip. He said they cannot go to New York, anywhere in New York, and find an OG that can say he put Tekashi on. He said, nope, he was just cool with him because he friends with him. He said he is a real blood, though. But, you know, they asked him, like, can you do that? Can you rock blue, then rock red? And his answer to the question pretty much was, no, if you all the way down with me in the Crip, no, you cannot rock blue, then rock red. But for some people who don't know the story, or even believe his story of he was just wearing blue because his friends was Crips, they not even going to be feeling, bro, you can be, you playing, you set tripping, you playing, you know what I'm saying? You playing with the culture a little bit. So a lot of folks who are a part of gang culture, they not going to be feeling that. Whether you was with them, or whether you was affiliated, whether you was a Crip, or whatever, they ain't with all that going back and forth stuff. But that was Tekashi's answer to the question. Now, this little meme right here came from Charlamagne asked him, told him that, you know, he going to be dead in a year. You know, he was copping lean on me. He said, if you don't change your ways, you're going to be dead in a year. Tekashi 21 years old. The dude's seeing all this money. And a lot of times when people are young and dumb and they getting a whole lot of money, you can't tell them nothing. So in a lot of ways, they couldn't tell Tekashi nothing. They even had his OG come on. And his OG, who really had some real good stuff to say, you know what I'm saying, was basically like, you know, I'm letting him do what he do because this is the culture of what they doing right now. These young guys out here doing their thing, so I'm going to let him be him. They even brought a pastor in there to pray for him. They even asked the pastor to pray for him. Now, personally, I have no issue with Tekashi 6ix9ine. When I watched the interview, I even understand him a little bit better by watching the interview. I knew he was Mexican, but I did not know his dad was Puerto Rican. You know, so it was a lot of things about 6ix9ine I did not know. Yeah, but make sure you check out the interview for yourself. It's a real good interview. Like I said, it's an hour long. Tekashi also said it's going to be the biggest interview that the Breakfast Club ever do. It's going to surpass any other numbers they have ever done on any other interview. You know, and it's also crazy. 6ix9ine mentioned Casanova while he was there. And Casanova and Slim 400 was sitting in them same damn chairs like the night before or the day before. Crazy. It's like all of them use the same studio. The Breakfast Club and Gwinnin, you know, on DJ Self. But anyway, man, let me know how you feel about the story. I am AKA Bands. This is Support This TV. Like, share, comment, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. I'm out. Peace.